When you think of Vikings, you might think of red-haired individuals with big horns on their helmets. In reality, the Vikings were some pretty violent people that engaged in some dark practices. From human sacrifices to the burning of bodies, let's talk about these and more only in today's video. Top 10 dark things the Vikings did. Starting off this countdown, we have Berserker. Between the 8th to mid 11th century, the Vikings were known to be very, very aggressive. In fact, when they were at battle, they would go into this trance-like state that was called Berserker. Once in this state, they would violently kill anyone who got in their way. Well, theory goes that this state was actually caused by eating magic mushrooms. Apparently, the mushrooms that grew in their area would cause hallucinations and would also increase their adrenaline levels, hence why they act so violently and out of control. Like, nowadays, people do shrooms and just chill out and watch Dora the Explorer. Imagine doing a whole battle while tripping out. In our ninth spot, we have the burning bodies. But before I go any further, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, because it really helps us out. In Norse religion, after death, it was said that warriors went into these great realms. But in order to get there, they needed a vessel. So when someone died back then, Vikings would place their body on a boat and push them off to sea. These boats were often surrounded by weapons and goods, even sometimes human sacrifices, all to help them get to their end destination. Not only that, but the more wealthy Vikings would actually burn the boat with the deceased on them and then push them out to sea. That's a pretty creepy image if you ask me, just watching a flaming dead body. Or bodies. In our 8th spot, we have the imbalance. Turns out that the Vikings were killing off so many women that they started having an uneven gender ratio. This was because men were considered stronger than women. Also because the Norse valued sons more than daughters. Over the years, archaeologists found tons of young female skeletons. So it was believed that they would get rid of them when they were young. Coming in at number 7, we have the teeth. Back in the day, Vikings would painfully file and dye their teeth. Archaeologists recently unearthed evidence of this. Basically, they would file their teeth down. Some would file horizontal parallel lines in their front two teeth, and some even dyed them, often red. Yeah, not white, red. And then the dye would seep into the carvings and stand out. Doesn't this kind of remind you of something? Yeah, everything is coming full circle. Remember that whole trend on TikTok of people filing down their own teeth by themselves? Wow. Now the purpose of this filing remains unclear, but some think it may have to do with their status as a great fighter. Other people believe that it was done to scare off their enemies. In our 6th spot, we have the bloody soup. This was a practice that women would use when caring for an injured Viking. It was used to gauge how bad their flesh wounds were. So basically, they would make a broth out of onions, leeks, and herbs. Then they would feed this to the injured Viking. After he finished eating it, they would then smell the wound. Yes, smell the wound. If they could smell the soup, then they knew the wound was way too deep and there was no sense helping the warrior. They would just die soon anyways. But if there was no smell, then good on them. The dude was good and they would actually treat them. Isn't that insane? Imagine if hospitals made us do that, like down a crap ton of onions and then sniff us. We are now at our 5th and halfway mark with the blood tasting. This is another really weird practice that the Vikings would do. So basically, women would use the blood of a wound to figure out more about the injury. They would do this by tasting the blood. I mean, there's not much information on this practice, but still, it's quite gross, but also kind of fascinating. Like, how could they tell the difference between a fatal wound and a non-fatal wound just by tasting someone's blood? Totally blows my mind. Again, thankfully, this isn't a practice doctors and nurses use today. Moving on at number 4, we have an eye for an eye. The Vikings had a pretty messed up justice system. Thank gosh, it's not like this still. But basically, killing someone wasn't always illegal. For example, they believed in an eye for an eye. So if someone, let's say, killed your wife, you could then kill the murderer. But then it would get complicated because then the murderer's family could kill you and then it would just be this this like perpetual killing cycle. They also had a thing called home gangs, which was a way of settling disputes. Basically, these were fights to the death. If one person did you wrong, you could ask them to a duel. If the person who was challenged doesn't show up, then they were deemed guilty, and anyone was allowed to kill that person. Again, I'm glad this isn't a thing anymore. In our third spot, we have the games. Obviously, they weren't playing jump rope or hopscotch for fun. No, they had some pretty dark games, like a swimming competition, except you're not swimming. In fact, you would hold your opponent underwater for as long as you could. If the man didn't resurface, then you won, and the dude died. So basically, they were playing murder. Moving on to number two, we have the human sacrifices. For a number of years, scientists believed Vikings did not partake in human sacrifice. That was until 1990, when an archaeologist made a quite interesting discovery. While using a metal detector, the archaeologist found jewelry and weapons along the edge of a lake. He kept digging and eventually came across evidence of human sacrifice that dated back to the Viking Age. Then in the 1930s, a series of ancient wells were excavated. That's when they found bone remnants of 5 people, again, suggesting this. According to Vikings, sacrifices helped re-establish their connection to the gods, and they would only do this when things were going bad for them. And in our number one spot, we have the Blood Eagle. Now this one is fairly graphic. Blood Eagle is a method of ritual execution. Basically, the victim would be restrained, their face down. Then the shape of an eagle with its wings out would be carved into their back. And then their ribs would be cut off, one by one. Finally, they would take the skin and pull it apart to make it look like a pair of wings. Ever seen the show Hannibal? It reminds me of that one episode from season one. If you know, you know. But it gets worse. You would still be alive while all of this happened. And then a saline solution would be poured all over your body. Okay, I can barely take hand sanitizer in a paper cut. So that would be brutal. The last step was taking the victim's lungs and spreading them over the wings. Alright guys, that's all for today's video. Let me know which one of these facts spooked you the most. Honestly, that eagle thing? Creepy. And now let's move on to our comment shout-out portion. I'll be shouting out comments from the video, Top 10 Scary Things That Happened in Circuses. Liliana Beach commented, please shout out me for being second. I have tried so hard to get a shout out, but never have. Well, thank you so much for trying. Finally, here's your shout out. There you go. Keep commenting if you want to be shouted out by me. Colin Henderson commented, Canada does have alligators. They're just furry and have flat tails. So beavers. No, sorry. They're just, you know, if an alligator and a beaver fought, this just not equal, okay? Clearly the beaver would win. Just kidding. Newman Outdoors commented, I didn't think there are very many circuses around anymore. I don't think so either. Especially now, in the times that we're in. But I think 3 summers ago, I went to a circus because I was a camp counselor and I brought them all there. Like, I didn't bring them. The camp all went to a circus, and it was pretty good. There was a couple of creepy clowns, not gonna lie, but it was more like a Cirque du Soleil performance, and I liked it. All right, guys, that's all the comments I'm showing out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in my next comment shout out. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see ya when I see ya. Archaeologists recently unearthed evidence of the ocean. Some would file horizontal. After he finished eating it. Then in the 1930s, a series of ancient wells were being excavated. Then in the 1930s, a series of ancient wells back.